Good morning, students. Now we are going to continue from the last session. We had learned about the restriction enzymes. So we will be continue from recombinant. This much only we last time we had learned that. Now we are going to continue from the remaining portion of that recombinant DNA technology. Do you know what palindromes are? One time we had learned in that palindrome sequence. Now we are going to learn more about the palindromes. So what is meant by palindromes? These are groups of letters that form the same words when read both forward and backward. Example, Malayalam, see that. From left to right also it will be read as Malayalam, and same from right to left also it will read as Malayalam. It reads. So these are the palindrome sequence are the group of letters. Palindrome sequence are the group of letters that form the same words when read both forward and backward. When read both forward and backward. Example, Malayalam. As against a word palindrome, where the same word is read in both directions. The palindrome in DNA is a sequence of base pairs. The palindrome in a DNA is the sequence of base pairs that reads same on the two strands. Like this one. Here we will be read CTTAAG. From here also it will be CTTAAG. Here GAATTC. Here GAATTC. So in the case of DNA, this is the palindrome. The literal meaning of palindrome means the word group of letters which can be read as same from both the ends. But here in the recombinant DNA technology, while we are coming to the DNA, like this only, both the DNA ends are in the same letters only, same base pairs like that. This example understood. G, A, A, T, T, C. Here also G, A, A, T, T, C. Same only. C, C, double T, double A, G. C, double T, double A, G. Like that words are coming as palindromic sequence. So, the palindrome in DNA is a sequence of base pairs. That reads same on the two strands when orientation of reading is kept the same only. For example, in the following sequence, reads the same on the two strands in 5' to 3' direction. This is also true if read in the 3' to 5' direction. G A A T T C. From here. This is, suppose this is from 5' to 3' we are reading as G double A double T C, and from 3' to 5' read G double A double T C. Restriction enzymes. Understood this one now. From 5' to 3' G double A double T C, and 3' to 5' C double T double H. Restriction enzymes cut the strand of DNA a little away from the center of the palindrome sites. But between the same two bases on the opposite strands. This leaves a single-stranded portion at the ends only. This single-stranded portion only we are seeing here. This is single-stranded. This single-stranded portion is calling us sticky end. Both the ends are single-stranded only. So these ends are called sticky ends only. So restriction enzymes cut the strand of DNA little away from the center of the palindrome sites, but between the same two bases on the opposite strands. This leaves single-stranded portions at the ends. There are overhanging stretches called sticky ends on each strand. These are named so because they form hydrogen bonds with their complementary cut counterparts. Hydrogen bonds with their complementary cut counterparts. The stickiness of the ends facilitates the action of the enzyme DNA ligase only. DNA ligase is the enzyme which is joining again. The sticky ends are again joined here now. For that, which enzyme is using for joining the DNA sticky ends are called ligase enzyme. The meaning of the word ligase is joining only. So the enzymes which are using to join something is called ligase enzyme. Here, ligase enzyme is used to join the sticky ends of both the DNA. Sticky ends of both the DNA. The meaning of sticky ends, three words we had learned here. Palindrome sequence. Are you understood the palindrome sequence? The sequence which can be read from 5 to 3 dash and same from 3 to 5 dash is also called as palindrome sequence. G, double A, T, T, C. Suppose this is from 5 dash to 3 dash. From 3 dash to 5 dash, the other strand is also reading the same only. G, double A, double T, C. So this restriction enzyme cutter and the remaining one strand is called as sticky ends. Remaining one strand is called a sticky ends. And again by using ligase enzyme, these sticky ends are joined. The sticky ends are joined by using the ligase enzyme. These are named so because they form hydrogen bonds with their complementary cut counterparts. They form hydrogen bonds with their complementary cut counterparts. The stickiness of the ends facilitates the action of the enzyme DNA ligase. Restriction endonuclease are used in genetic engineering to form recombinant molecules of DNA. Restriction endonuclease are used in genetic engineering to form recombinant molecules of DNA, which are composed of DNA from different sources of genomes. Restriction endonucleases are used in genetic engineering to form recombinant molecules of DNA, which are composed of DNA from different sources of genomes. When cut by the same restriction enzymes, the resultant DNA fragments have the same kind of sticky ends. When cut by the same restriction enzymes, the resultant DNA fragments have the same kind of sticky ends, and these can be joined together end to end using DNA ligase. End to end using DNA ligase. Foreign DNA, vector DNA. So how this DNA is cut here, and here also cut. Then now this fragment, this is the fragment required. Both the ends are cut. Now these fragments will be joined here. Here it is joined by using the ligase enzyme. Ligases join foreign DNA to plasmid. First foreign DNA is selected. The foreign DNA which we are selecting here is the DNA which is containing some desirable genes. Which type of genes we want? That only we are joining in another organism. So the DNA which is containing desirable genes and cutting by using restriction enzyme. Same restriction enzyme is using to cut the host organism also, vector also. So by same enzyme using means it will be cut at the same palindrome sequence. So sticky ends are forming, so easily they can be sticked to each other. So ligases join foreign DNA to plasmid. And afterwards it is, now this recombinant DNA is formed here. This is introduced into another organism for multiply its number only. By when cells divide, its number also multiplied. So lower organism which can be multiplied very fast. The multiplication rate of each organism is very high. That type of organism only selected. So E. coli bacteria which have the multiplication rate is very very high only, that already we had learned in 11th. So that type of, because of that only many times E. coli bacteria are selecting. So when E. coli cells divide, now one cell divided into two, this recombinant DNA is used to both the cells. Now each of the cells divided one more time, then four cells will be there. So this recombinant DNA is sitting in four cells. Then 4 to 8, 8 to 16, like that it will be multiplied. So foreign DNA, recombinant DNA technology asking means you have to draw this diagram also. So foreign DNA selected, how it should be selected the foreign DNA? Foreign DNA selected in such a way that it should contain some desirable genes. Which one we want? Desirable genes. So that portion of the DNA contained by using a restriction endonucleus enzyme. If it is restriction endonucleus only use the, because it is cut from inside only. If external portion like that we have to cut, then exonuclease is used. External portion we want to be cut, then an exonuclease. Now here in the example, endonuclease only used because internal portion only cut. Understood? And from by using same restriction endonuclease and same only vector DNA also cut. And afterwards, this cut fragments is joining, ligases join foreign DNA to plasma. Foreign DNA to plasma. Transformation, cells divide. Diagrammatic representation of recombinant DNA technology. You may have realized that normally, unless one cuts the vector, and the source DNA with the same restriction enzyme, the recombinant vector molecule cannot be created. You may have realized that normally, unless one cuts the vector and the source DNA, means which one is alien DNA, providing one. Who is providing the DNA with the desirable gene is considered a source of DNA. So unless one cuts the vector and source DNA with the same restriction and same only using, the recombinant vector molecule cannot be created. The reason you might be understood that if you see here that if same restriction and same are using, then only this complementary sticky end we will be get. Of complementary base pair of T, A, T to A, A to T and A to T. Like that complementary base pair or complementary sticky end we are getting when we are using the same restriction and otherwise we cannot be put the recombinant DNA technology. That one you already understood. So unless one cuts the vector and the source DNA with the same restriction and same, the recombinant vector molecule cannot be created. Now we are going to the next topic, that is separation and isolation of DNA fragments. Now we, by using restriction endonuclease or exonuclease enzyme, we cut the DNA fragments. Now how it should be separated or isolated, that only we are going to, that is the second step of the recombinant DNA technology. The cutting of DNA by restriction endonuclease results in the fragments of DNA. These fragments can be separated by a technique known as gel electrophoresis. The cutting of DNA by restriction endonuclease results in the fragments of DNA. These fragments can be separated by a technique known as gel electrophoresis. Since DNA fragments are negatively charged molecule, they can be separated by forcing them to move it towards the anode, under an electric field through a medium or matrix. Since DNA fragments are negatively charged, what is the charge of DNA fragments? Negatively charged molecule, they can be separated, forcing them to move it towards the anode. Anode is the positive electrode only. So DNA fragments are negatively charged. DNA fragments go and stick on the anode, which is positively charged electron. Opposite charges having the attraction. So DNA fragments are negatively charged. So it go and stick on the anode only. Anode is the positive electron by opposite charges. This method is used in calling as electrophoresis. This method is called separation of something using this method is called the electrophoresis. So here we are using the technique gel electrophoresis. Since DNA fragments are negatively charged molecules, they can be separated by forcing them to move towards the anode under an electric field through a medium matrix. Nowadays, the most commonly used matrix is agarose. Agarose, which is a natural polymer extracted from seaweeds. Nowadays, the most commonly used matrix is agarose, a chemical substance it is, which is natural polymer extracted from seaweeds. agar. Agar is already we had learned in Nilavanda. Is producing from algae only, agar seaweeds. The DNA fragments separate according to their size through sieving effect only. Sieving all of you know, filtering effect provided by the agarose gel. Sieving effect is provided by the agarose gel. Hence, the smaller the fragment size, farther it moves. If suppose the DNA fragment is smaller in size, it moves farther, farther. If the DNA fragment is long, then it cannot move farther, so it will be deposited nearer. So look at the figure 11.3, we will be seeing that. And the end of the gel, the sample was loaded. This is the diagram given. These are the walls where from where we are keeping the DNA fragment. Agarose gel is used in this one. Agarose gel are used. So DNA bands are there. Largest one is here only. It is well only well means they from where we are introducing the DNA fragment is called the well. As these DNA fragments are larger in size, they are not going farther. They are depositing near to that well only. Near to that well. But which one is smallest? As they are lighter in weight, they can go farther. So they are deposited here only. Understood? So well is the region from where we are introducing the DNA fragments to separate it into longer one and a smaller one, shorter one and a longer one. So according to the theory, DNA fragments which are longer, having more weight, you know, so it cannot go farther. It will be deposited near to that well only. And smaller fragments, as they are lighter in weight, it can be go to farther. So it will be deposited. This region only. So both of them are separate. Here the gel used is the agarose gel only. Agarose gel is used in the separate DNA fragments according to their sieving, according to their size only. Agarose gel is used in the separate DNA fragments according to their size through sieving effect provided. Smaller fragment size, farther it moves. That is showing by this diagram. These are the smallest one and largest one near to that well only. The separated DNA fragments can be visualized only after staining the DNA with a compound known as ethidium bromide, followed by exposure to ultraviolet radiation. The separated DNA fragments can be visualized only after staining the DNA. Only after staining the DNA with a compound known as ethidium bromide, followed by exposure to ultraviolet radiation. Because we cannot see pure DNA fragments in the visible light. By that only ultraviolet radiation is using there, because normal or visible light we cannot be see the DNA fragments. So we cannot see pure DNA fragments in the visible light, and without staining, pure means without staining, we cannot see. So here ultraviolet radiation used. So you can see bright orange colored bands of DNA. This orange color is colored, stained it is. You can see bright orange colored bands of DNA in an ethidium bromide stained gel exposed to ultraviolet light. The separated bands of DNA are cut. Now it is separated, DNA bands can be cut out from the agarose gel and extracted from the gel piece. This step is known as elution. This step is called the elution. So what is elution? The separated bands of DNA are cut out from the agarose gel and extracted from the gel piece. This step is known as the elution. The DNA fragments purified in this way are used in constructing recombinant DNA by joining them with the cloning methods. The DNA fragments purified in this way are used in constructing recombinant DNA by joining them with the cloning methods. A typical agarose gel electrophoresis is only shown here. Migration of undigested, lane one is undigested one only, larger one. And the digested set of fragments from 2 to 4. So now we are going to learn about cloning vectors. We know that plasmid and bacteriophages have the ability to replicate within bacterial cells. We already learned in 11th like that plasmid and bacteriophages have the ability to replicate within bacterial cell. Replicate within bacterial cell independent of the control of the chromosomal DNA. Independent of the control of the chromosomal DNA. That principle is used in this one. Plasmid and bacteriophages have the ability to replicate within bacterial cell independent of the control of chromosomal DNA. Bacteriophages, because of their high number per cell, have very high copy numbers of their genome within the bacterial cell. Some plasmids may have only 1 or 2 copies per cell, whereas others may have 15 to 100 copies per cell. So very high speed, very high copy numbers they can be given. As their multiply rate is very high copies are have very high copy numbers of their genome within the bacterial cell. Some plasmid may have only 1 or 2 copies per cell, whereas others may have 15 to 100 copies per cell. Like that, copy numbers also vary. Bacteriophages, because of their high number per cell, have very high copy numbers of their genome within the bacterial cell. Some plasmids may have only 1 or 2 copies per cell, whereas others may have 15 to 100 copies per cell. Their numbers can go even higher. Higher numbers, number of copy can be vary from cell to cell. Their numbers can go even higher than this also. If we are able to link an alien piece of DNA with the bacteriophage of plasmid DNA, we can multiply its numbers equal to the copy number of the plasmid, equal to the copy number of the plasmid or bacteriophage. We can multiply its numbers equal to the copy number of the plasmid or bacteriophage. Vectors used to present are engineered in such a way that they help easy linking of foreign DNA. Vectors used to present are engineered in such a way that they help easy linking of foreign DNA and selection of recombinants from non-recombinants. And selection of recombinants from you have to identify that which are the recombinant DNA and which are the non-recombinant DNA. So here vectors are, now which vectors are using, they are made in such a way that they help easy linking of foreign DNA, easy linking of foreign DNA and selection of recombinants from non-recombinants. So now we are going to learn about the features that are required to facilitate cloning into a vector. Features that are required to facilitate cloning into a vector. This question last year asked this question. It is very important question. Along with this diagram, it is asked that biotechnology first time you may be learning. You are learning first time only. So you are thinking that it is difficult. One to ten reading after seeing the video, you can understand it easily. So the following are the features that are required to facilitate cloning into a vector are Orginov replication. Orginov replication already we had learned in short form, it is polymorphism, ORI. Orginov replication, selectable marker that we will learn now. Cloning sites. Cloning sites, three things are needed. Three things are needed. Orginov replication, features required to facilitate cloning into a vector. What are the features required to facilitate cloning into a vector? Cloning into a vector. That is Orginov replication, selectable marker, cloning sites. Cloning sites. That we are going to learn. This is a sequence from where replication starts, and any piece of DNA when linked to the sequence can be made to replicate within the host cell. Within the host cell. This sequence is also responsible for controlling the copy number of the linked DNA, controlling the copy number, how many copy number is needed, how many copies are producing, that is depending upon genome replication. From this region only replication also originating, so it is called genome replication. Moreover, controlling the copy number of the linked DNA. So if he wants to recover many copies of the targeted DNA, it should be cloned into a vector whose origin support high copy number. So like that we have to select that. If we need a high copy number means how many times it multiply. So if we need a high copy number, we have to select a vector in such a way that which vector is having the capacity of high copy for the original replication. So if one wants to recover many copies of the targeted DNA, it should be cloned in such a way that the vector whose origin support the high copy number. Second, it is selectable marker only. Original replication is shown here. OR. This is the original replication in this diagram. And second thing needed is selectable marker. In addition to ORIN, a vector requires a selectable marker, which helps in identifying and eliminating non-transformants and selectively permitting the growth of the transformants. In addition to ORIN, the vector requires a selectable marker, which helps in identifying and eliminating non-transformants and selectively permitting the growth of the transformants. Transformation is a procedure through which a piece of DNA is introduced. In a host bacterium. Normally, the genes encoding resistance to antibiotics such as ampicillin, chloramphenicol, tetracycline, or kanamycin, etc., are considered useful selectable markers for E. coli. The normal E. coli cells do not carry resistance against any of these antibiotics. Cloning sites. So in order to link the alien DNA, the vector needs to have very few, preferably single recognition sites for the commonly used restriction enzyme. Presence of more than one recognition site within the vector will generate, several fragments, which will complicate the gene cloning. The ligation, means joining of alien DNA is carried out at a restriction site present in one of the two antibiotic resistance. We had already learned that the ampicillin and the tetracycline. Two antibiotic resistant genes. For example, you can ligate a foreign DNA at the BAM H1. Here, tetracycline gene is there. Resistance gene is there. So, the ligation of alien DNA is carried out at a restriction site present in one of the two antibiotic resistance genes. For example, you can ligate a foreign DNA at the BAM H1 site of tetracycline resistant genes in the vector PBR322. The recombinant plasmid will lose tetracycline resistance, because we had joined there only. So the recombinant plasmid will lose tetracycline resistant due to insertion of foreign DNA. There only foreign DNA is inserted. So it is losing that capacity of resisting tetracycline antibiotics. But it can still be selected out from non-recombinant ones by plating the transformants on ampicillin containing medium. Another resistance gene is there, ampicillin. The transformants growing on ampicillin containing medium are then transferred into a medium containing tetracycline. That way we can. The recombinants will grow in ampicillin containing medium but not on that containing tetracycline because they are having resistance against ampicillin containing medium. Because already they lost by the introduction of new DNA to there, they lost the capacity of tetracycline resistance. So they cannot be leaving tetracycline now because they lose the capacity of tetracycline resistance. Now they can live in ampicillin containing medium, but the non-recombinants will grow on the medium containing both the antibiotics. Non-recombinants, they are having both the resistance, ampicillin resistance also and the tetracycline resistance. So non-recombinants will be living both the medium. In this case, one antibiotic resistant cell in selecting the transformants, whereas the other antibiotic resistance gene gets inactivated due to insertion of variant DNA and fails in selection of recombinants. So this diagram also, you have ampicillin resistant gene, tetracycline resistant. First recombinant DNA was produced by Stanley Cohen and Herbert Boyer. Stanley Cohen and Herbert Boyer. They isolated an antibiotic resistant gene from a plasmid of Salmonella typhimurium. It was linked with a plasmid vector and transferred into E. coli. As a result, the gene was expressed and multiplied in E. coli. The process of joining and inserting a foreign DNA. Tools of recombinant DNA technology. Restriction enzyme, molecular scissors. Restriction enzyme cutting the DNA, so it is also calling as molecular scissors. Cloning, tetracycline resistant portion blue color and ampicillin resistant genes green color. Origin of replication given in pink.